Let's talk about dumb phones, or feature phones as they're often called, which really is a better nickname for them than flip phones, because not all dumb phones are flip phones, and there's even some smartphones that have that flipping capability now. But these phones, they seem to be making a little bit of a comeback amongst certain people, but I think that people are buying them for the wrong reasons. There seems to be a lot of misconceptions about them. For example, people that want to increase their online privacy, a lot of the time they'll be interested in these dumb phones because they think that it's going to reduce the tracking that can be done by them. Now, I've mentioned in these privacy-related videos several times that anytime that you want to prevent tracking or increase your security, you've got to have a threat model. You've got to, you know, talk about what it is, or you've got to kind of map out in your mind what it is you're trying to defend against. You know, is it governments? Is it corporations? I guess in this case, we can treat them sort of as the same thing because they're really in bed with one another when it comes to cellular tracking. Now, the thing about dumb phones is that they're still receiving a cellular service. And when you have cellular service, you're being tracked. Okay, you can be triangulated with cell phone towers and it can pinpoint your location down to about 3 or 4 city blocks or 3/4 of a square mile. And obviously, if you're connected to more, that location pinpointing can be done even more accurately. But cellular service, by its very nature, is tracking. These companies, they record every text message that you make, every phone call that you make. They're tracking where that phone goes throughout the day, which pretty much is going to track where the person goes. And they collect all of this information for their own use, but then they also send it off to three-letter agencies and they analyze that data and then they correlate it with any other data that they collect from you, you know, credit card spending, CCTV footage, anything else like that. So there's still tracking that's going on with the cellular service. Now, one pretty good thing about dumb phones is that they usually have removable batteries. And this is often seen as a surefire way to defeat tracking, because obviously removing the SIM card, that's not enough to prevent tracking. You can still make emergency calls when a SIM card is removed from your phone. So clearly it's still sending and receiving signals to a cell tower. But it's very unwise to just assume that removing the battery is going to remove any signals that are getting sent to the phone, or that it's actually truly turning your phone off, because most phones these days, they actually come with a secondary battery inside of them. And, you know, as far as we know, their official function is for it to pretty much work like a CMOS battery. And a CMOS battery, it's just that little coin-sized battery that exists inside of all laptops and desktops. It's pretty much responsible for maintaining the time on the device as well as the BIOS settings. This is why if you unplug your desktop, for example, and you plug it back in a couple hours later, it's still going to have an accurate time on it. And you can actually do a pretty simple test to see if your cell phone has one of these secondary batteries on it. All you have to do is put it in airplane mode, remove the SIM card, take note of the time that's on the phone, and then remove the battery and wait maybe 10 minutes or so, plug the battery back in. And if your phone still has accurate time, then clearly there's a secondary power source that is making it keep that time, that's keeping the phone running. So then it really just becomes a question of what is this secondary battery capable of doing? It's connected to the same circuitry as the primary battery, so it could, in theory, be used to power things like GPS, the baseband processor, the microphone, and even the camera. Especially if these things were to be enabled in a low power mode and only send periodic transmissions instead of constant ones like they do with the primary battery plugged in. Or maybe the phone isn't actually powerful enough in this state to send a transmission all the way to a cellular tower. But what if a Stingray were to be deployed just nearby, the phone's last known whereabouts, so that whoever owns that Stingray tries to snoop on it? Now, obviously, an operation like this would only be conducted by the Glowboys whenever something really piques their interest, whenever there's a person that they're really interested in tracking. But I bring it up to nail home the point that removing that battery isn't really the end all to tracking. That secondary battery could be doing other things, and we don't know exactly what it does because cell phone manufacturers don't really release all of their blueprints and all their schematics about what every single piece in the phone does, what it's capable of doing. It's really easy for a government agency to just say, hey, you know, we want you to put this slightly more powerful CMOS battery inside of the cell phone so that we can use it to do additional tracking if some weirdo wants to rip the battery out of their phone. Now, there's also the issue of standing out. So every single device has unique IDs that are associated with it. These are your MAC address, your IMEI, and your IMSI. Now, MAC addresses, they can be spoofed fairly easily, so we aren't going to really worry about that. But the IMSI and the IMEI are quite a bit trickier to change. And they uniquely identify your cellular service as well as the device's unique ID respectively. And whenever you buy a new device, the IMEI is scanned. Most POSs won't even actually let you sell a device unless this is scanned by the employee that's working there. And if you make an electronic payment to purchase that phone, then it's instantly going to be connected to you, assuming that it's your credit card that you use to buy it with. Now, maybe you're smart enough to purchase this phone and the cellular service anonymously with cash, but these would still be tracked as a cash purchase, which might make the cell phone and the service that much more suspicious to the feds. I would imagine that they have some kind of a Google Maps-like program that shows them the last known location of all of the cell phones that are in the United States or, you know, in the world, wherever else they're operating, and it ranks them by how suspicious they are. So something like an iPhone that is purchased with a credit card and is using a mainstream cell service like Verizon and is running apps like Facebook and Snapchat, this would probably be ranked as a low suspicion. And if for whatever reason the Glowboys decide that they want to look into that person's life, they could easily do so since so much data is being collected by that phone and the person's activity that they're doing on it. But if they notice a dumb phone with a burner cellular service that's all purchased with cash, that is periodically going offline by having its battery removed, well, that sticks out like a sore thumb. Clearly, whoever is operating that device and using it that way, at the very least, has some really high security concerns. You know, or maybe they're doing something illegal, right? Maybe they're building machine guns or selling drugs or doing some other naughty stuff that the feds can investigate and then try to justify their salaries with. Either way, this kind of device is going to attract more attention. It's going to be more suspicious and will ultimately lead to more intense tracking being done on it. Now, I would recommend if you want to avoid being tracked unnecessarily, you should either not own a cell phone at all or just use an Android phone that you can root and then de-Google to prevent the built-in apps from tracking your every move, or you could install a custom ROM that doesn't come with all of those spooky apps in the first place. Now, getting outside of privacy and tracking and all that stuff, there's another group of people that likes to buy these phones for the sole reason that they don't have social media on them or that they don't have internet on them at all. Now, social media addiction, it is a real thing. You can just go on public transit and you'll probably see that everybody is staring at their phones, you know, constantly checking Twitter or Instagram or Reddit, whatever it is that they do on there. Now, I come from the mindset that developing self-discipline is the most important thing that you can do in your life. But I realize that not everybody is able to do that. Maybe it's just a lack of willpower. Maybe some people are genetically predisposed to have less willpower. Whatever the reason is, if you can't control yourself, if you don't have that self-discipline and that willpower, then I guess the next best approach to dealing with an addiction is to just abstain. Create a system of abstinence so that you can't get out of control in the first place. But what really annoys me is that a lot of people that have these addictions, whether it's, you know, alcohol, drugs, or cell phones in this case, they tend to project that addiction onto other people. They'll sort of look at anybody else who's using a cell phone or wants to go get a drink at a bar. They're like, oh man, you've got a problem. You know, you should give up your phone like I did and disconnect from social media and your life will be so much better. You know, if you're in a better, healthier place because you gave up your smartphone, then that's great. I'm happy for you. But don't act like this change puts you above everybody else when in reality, it just brought you up to the baseline. You weren't able to control yourself, so you just made it a little bit more difficult for you to get out of control in the first place. Smartphones, they can do a lot of useful things outside of Candy Crush and Facebook. I like to use them for some of those things. So yeah, if you want to buy a dumb phone, go for it. Just don't have misconceptions about it. Don't think it makes you invisible to glow boys. And don't think it ultimately makes you a better person because you can't access social media from it.